In this video, we're going to integrate the sine of the sine of x solution. So we'll start by writing down the Maclaurin series for sine x. So sine x has a Maclaurin series, and since sine is an odd function, it has only odd powers of x in the Maclaurin series. So the first odd power of x is 1, so we have x to the 1, which is x. And then the sines alternate, so the next one is minus, and the next odd power is 3, so it's x to the 3 over 3 factorial. And then the next one is plus, and it's x to the 5 over 5 factorial, etc. So that's the Maclaurin series for sine. So now what we will do is we will replace this x with sine x, right? So then we have sine of the sine of x. So replacing our first x with sine x, we get sine x, this is pretty cool, minus, and then here we have sine x, and then the whole thing here is cubed over 3 factorial, plus, and then here we have sine x to the 5 over 5 factorial, minus dot, dot, dot. All right, so now we just have to integrate each of these pieces, right? So let's see. So let's start off by integrating the sine function. So when you integrate sine, we have the integral of sine x with respect to x. You ask yourself, what's a function whose derivative is sine? Well, the derivative of cosine is negative sine, so this will just be negative cosine. I won't bother to write the plus c. By the way, basically we're integrating both sides of this equation, right? The original question was to integrate the sine of the sine of x, right? So we're just going to integrate each term one by one. Let's go ahead and integrate this next one. For now, I'll ignore the negative 1 over 3 factorial. Let's just focus on sine cubed. So whenever you have sine to an odd power like 3, 5, or 7, or 9, the strategy is to save a copy of sine and convert the rest to cosines, and you let your u be cosine. So in this case, we have sine squared times sine x. Beautiful stuff. And we know that sine squared is 1 minus cosine squared. So this is parentheses 1 minus cosine squared x sine x dx. And now we'll let u be cosine. So let's do that. So u is going to be cosine. That means that du is the derivative of cosine, so that's negative sine x dx. And then we have to make this look like what's in our integrand, so we can multiply by negative 1. So we get negative du equals sine x dx. So replacing sine x dx with negative du, we're going to get negative parentheses 1 minus, and then cosine was u, so u squared, and then this here is our du. Let me just check that. So we replace sine x dx with negative du, and then u with cosine. Yep. Let's go ahead and distribute that negative 1, so it's going to be u squared minus 1 du. And now we can integrate each piece using the power rule, right? So u squared is going to turn into u cubed over 3, but u is cosine, right? So this will be cosine cubed x over 3 minus u, but u is cosine, so minus u, and I won't bother to write the plus c. So we've taken care of the second one. We still have to have the 1 over 3 factorial. No worries, I haven't forgotten. So I'm going to put this in a box, and remind myself that there is a negative 1 over 3 factorial here that we have to add later. Let's do one more. Let's do sine to the fifth power. Let's do it. So we have sine to the fifth power of x dx. So in this case, just like before, you have an odd power of sine, so it means you want to save a sine, convert the rest to cosines, and let u be cosine. So we have sine to the fourth of x, and then here we have sine x dx. Just like before. Now sine to the fourth is sine squared squared, right? It's really sine squared x squared. So that's really 1 minus cosine squared x squared. So that's what we have. We have parentheses 1 minus cosine squared x squared sine x dx. All right, then we do exactly the same thing, right? We let u equal cosine x. So we're going to let u equal cosine x so that du is negative sine x dx. And again, we want to make this look like what's in our integrand. So there's no negative in our integrand, so we'll multiply by negative 1. So we get negative du equals sine x dx. All right, so this is equal to, I'm going kind of fast because it's a lot of integration, right? It's pretty hardcore. Minus integral parentheses 1 minus u squared squared. And then here we have our du. Good stuff. We can multiply this out using like some math. If you have a minus b squared, you square the a, you subtract, you put a 2ab, right? You multiply the a and the b and you double it and you add b squared. So we'll do that here. We get minus, so it'll be 1 minus 2u squared plus, and then you square the u squared, that gives you u to the fourth. And then we have our du, right? Just being really careful here. What a wreck. let's go ahead and integrate this and distribute the negative at the same time. It's going to be negative u, okay, then plus 2, right? It's going to be plus 2 u cubed over 3, and then minus u to the 5 over 5, right? And then what we have now, I didn't put the c, I'm ignoring the c's, is u is cosine x. This is negative cosine x plus 2/3, okay, and then it's going to be cosine cubed minus 1/5 cosine to the 5th of x. I'm going to put this in a box, and I'm again ignoring the c, and I believe we had a number up top. Yeah, we had a 5 factorial. So I'll put that here just to remind myself. All right, let's rewrite everything we have. Let's do this. So recap, what have we done? So we have the indefinite integral of the sine of x dx, right? That's equal to the integral of, and then we have the infinite sum, right? So parentheses, sine x minus, and then we have sine of x quantity cubed over 3 factorial plus, then we have parentheses sine of x to the 5 over 5 factorial minus dot 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 parentheses dx like a pro. And then we're just going to integrate each piece. This is equal to, so let's see, when we integrated sine, we did that way up here, we got negative cosine. So we get negative cosine x. And now we have minus 1 over 3 factorial times the integral of sine cubed, right? So we integrated sine cubed up here. Here it is. It's right here. So, I didn't put u. U here is cosine x. What a noob move. So cosine x. So it's going to be cosine cubed x over 3 minus cosine x. So it'll be, let me write that down again. So cosine cubed x over 3. Minus cosine x. And that has something on the outside, right? That has a negative 1 over 3 factorial. So I ran out of room, so I'll squeeze it in here. Negative 1 over 3 factorial. Plus 1 over 5 factorial. And then we have our other piece here. You can still see it. Negative cosine x plus 2/3 cosine cubed x minus 1/5 cosine to the 5th x, okay, cosine to the 5th x, and then, you know, et cetera, right, et cetera, dot, dot, dot. So this is going to be equal to negative cosine x, distributing the negative 1 over 3 factorial, 3 factorial is 6, right, 6 times 3 is 18, so minus 1 over 18 cosine cubed x plus 1 over 6 cosine x, because we can combine these at some point, right? And then over here we have this 1 over 5 factorial. 5 factorial is 120. So this is minus 1 over 120 cosine x. And then again, 5 factorial is 120. So we have 2/3 times 1 over 120, right? So that means that 2 goes into 120 60 times. It's 1 over 180. This is completely ridiculous. This is plus 1 over 180 cosine cubed x. And then now it's getting out of hand. 5 factorial times 5, that's 120 times 5. That's 600. Oh my God, 600. So this is minus 1 over 600 cosine to the 5th x plus dot, dot, dot. Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Let's not give up now. This is equal to, so there's a negative 1 here, okay, and there's a 1/6 here, and there's a negative 1 over 120 here. So I'm going to cheat and use my calculator. So negative 1 plus 1/6 minus 1 over 120. So negative 1 plus 1/6 minus 1 over 120. Okay, that's a crazy number. Okay, I got, so combining this, this, and this, okay, we get negative 101 over 120 cosine x. And then combining this and this, and remember, there's more pieces here that are missing, right? I mean, we can go on forever, but we won't, because we can't go on forever, because we'll die. Plus 1 over 180, math. Okay, so here we go, negative 1 over 20 cosine cubed x. This is ridiculous. Then minus 1 over 600 cosine to the 5th x. And it just goes on. It just goes on forever and forever and forever. So I hope that made sense.